It's a 3-1 advancing to declining stocks. A lot of hope, of course, on the trade negotiations over the weekend and at least some positive outcomes. Positive for the market would be no new tariffs. That's what everybody is wanting, even if negotiations continue here. There's your semis trade proxy. There's China shares here in the U.S., another trade proxy. Banks have been a lot more stable recently in the last few weeks. Industrials, this is flat. This is Boeing. Boeing's down 2.5%. It's really pushing the industrials down. Energy, of course, not doing too much, although it had a good start to the week yesterday here. We're finishing the first half of the year, and everybody after these negotiations is going to turn to the earnings situation in the second half of the year, because we've got a little bit of a problem here. The good news is there's no earnings recession. We're not dropping. There's no negative earnings quarters that are happening. Buybacks are continuing very strong, particularly for technology stocks. It's looking a lot like 2018 in terms of buybacks, but earnings are flattish. Now, we had a great year in 2018, folks, so you might say, hey, flattish is not bad, but markets are at new high. We need a little more justification for these kinds of prices with just earnings flattish. Here's the problem that we're looking at. This is what I mean, I say flattish. Here's your four quarters, 1.6, 0.3, 0.9, and they're hoping for a big move up in the fourth quarter, but that's a lot of hopium right there. Essentially, we're talking about 2% a year for the year. That's the optimistic scenario. But we've had all sorts of problems this year. Tech has been the big issue because of trade and tariff and the global slowdown. The tech numbers have been terrible. Look, three quarters here. Technology earnings have been declining. Everyone has got the hopium going in the fourth quarter. That's why they seized on Micron's comments yesterday that everything's going to suddenly turn around and get a little bit better. So there's a scenario that the bulls have been pushing on the market that so far the market, frankly, is buying. Here's the scenario that people are expecting right now. This is called, it's the 2019 bull playbook, if you want. We get the tariff deals. No new tariffs are going to occur. Talks will continue. Maybe tariffs continue. The existing tariffs continue. The market is fine with that kind of scenario. Number two, this is the essential critical component. Fed will backstop the market. So you're going to get several consecutive cuts in the interest rate scenario. And what's going to happen is that is going to lift the earnings picture for the third and fourth quarter. So the flattish earnings that everyone is looking at right now will improve in the third and fourth quarter. And the bulls point to June. They said, look what happened the minute the Fed turned around and said, hey, we're thinking about cutting rates. The declines in the earnings estimates stopped immediately. And everyone started saying, oh, maybe the numbers are going to be a little bit better. Maybe we can lift it. So there's your scenario here. The market is primed for this right now. Finally, one thing about IPOs, we had a rare miss today. Remember what a spectacular market this has been in the IPOs? People have been pricing at the high end and opening on the first day well above it. We didn't have this with Change Healthcare today, big healthcare billing software company. 16 to 19 was the price talk. Wait a minute, it's pricing over the NASDAQ at 13. Now, this is a highly levered deal. It's a Blackstone deal, so maybe there's some that old, we don't like the leverage that's involved, we don't like the debt that's involved, but in an IPO market that's been nothing short of spectacular on the year, this is a rare miss. This will be opening in the next hour or so, and we'll see how it opens.